Joining me now, former White House Special Advisor Michael Allen.
Michael Allen was a former senior director on the National Security Council in the George W. Bush White House. He's currently managing director of Beacon Global Strategies.
Former National Security Senior Director for Counterproliferation Strategy is Michael Allen, and he's here with us now. Let me bring in now Michael Allen, former special assistant to President George W. Bush.
But I'm not sure the world really got on board with the idea that he would just brazenly invade another country, use thermobaric weapons, otherwise kill hundreds, maybe thousands of civilians. This, I think, was a shock to many. I don't think it was a shock to us here in the United States, but it certainly shocked Europe, and I'm glad that Europe is stepping up. And it's
at the beginning of the administration, we were supposed to lengthen and strengthen the deal. Instead, what the Biden administration did was ask for changes, accept Iran's no for an answer, and now we're actually getting less for more. So when you have such zeal for the deal, a deal at any cost, Israel and our other allies in the region are rightfully asking, do you have any more commitment to us here in the region, or are you just checking out to move on to bigger priorities?
He's got to know what his goals are going in, because if you want a deal badly enough, you're going to get a bad deal. So we need to make sure that we are tough and angle for the right things.
Yeah, when I worked down at the National Security Council and they brought down the sensitive reporting, they would always have it cloaked in two or three envelopes and watch you read it. So it's very, very sensitive information.
I don't know that this is calculated very well to get Iran to cave at this moment, but I think there is a little bit of method to the madness.
Michael Allen, Trump whisperer on the world stage. That was impressive, Michael. I mean,
so how significant is this expulsion of diplomats?
It's significant enough in that if we are taking down serious intelligence officers and getting them out of the game, thereby freeing up some FBI resources, it is significant. But look, this has happened for decades. They're just going to rebuild. They, by all accounts, have the highest number of intelligence officers in Washington and around the United States than even during the Cold War. I mean, this is
more now than during the Cold
War. Yeah, this is an open congressional testimony. They are more aggressive than they ever have been.
And then Michael Allen, I love following him. He's really, really smart and plugged in on all things foreign policy, so he'll be there to kick us off today.
Talking about
just
Ukraine.
This. I think it's for all of this. I think he's disappointed he couldn't get as far as Odessa, but I think he wants to keep all of this. You keep saying the land bridge, you're exactly right. That's part of it.
By the way, somebody moved Odessa. That's supposed to be over there.
Maybe I did it.
Michael Allen, good to see you. Thanks so much.